Our adventure today begins right off the main route, Route 95 in Nevada, in Searchlight, Nevada. Before we start off our episode today, I just wanted to take a look at the Mojave Desert. Some of the beautiful Joshua trees that inhabit this area in Yucca. Absolutely beautiful desert. My favorite desert to date.
Howdy, friends. It's Glenn with the Cactus Atlas in the frigid Mojave Desert. We're gonna be seeking out some ghost towns today. So to call Searchlight a full-fledged ghost town is probably not accurate. There's a population today. I read somewhere maybe south of 500 people, so not the most populous town in Nevada, but there's a lot of history here, and we're gonna go seek it out.
And just to really give you a look here, downtown Searchlight is down that way. We're facing south, and Slim is parked down at the bottom of that hill by a pile of tailings. And right up the hill, like I said, this is amazing. There's an old mine with a small headframe, what I presume is a headframe, as well as the equipment that they would have used to probably haul up carts of ore out of this mine. This is spectacular though. You could see this is a real mine. And I'm sure this is the same device they would have used to haul ore out of that mine, which you can now see has a protective grate over it. They filled it in, so they probably dumped a bunch of material in there and put that grate there. I'm assuming they didn't fill it in all the way to keep a habitat for bats. You see that a lot in the Southwest. It's kind of a rarity to find things like this anymore laying about in the desert, because in the read in the World War II age, when they shut a lot of mining operations down, they took a lot of the metal as scrap to fuel the war effort. So it's really neat when you come across stuff like this. Presumably the machinery that would have worked with this hoist system here.
Don't you worry, as we head into town, we'll talk about some of the history of Searchlight, of course. Drop some facts on you. We're starting off, we're doing a warm-up here. Looking out into the Mojave, studying the regions that we're gonna be traveling. Somewhere way out there into the Mojave Desert today is our destination. Got some really cool places mapped out. All right, so I'm standing where I think there once was a, I don't know if it was a workshop or something. It was made of wood with, like, you know, iron or corrugated tin roof, rusted out. The stereotypical thing that you would expect to see. And I was watching some fellow YouTubers that explored this area over the years, and if I'm right about this location, I'm wondering if there's a fire. This just goes to show you how fragile and temporary these old sites are. It doesn't take much. A fire, wind, just the elements to knock things down. You usually only find these remaining foundations, which make it harder to fill out what the place would have looked like back in the day. But
this right here is a huge reason why I feel compelled to make these videos, because you could even see, you know, just in our lifetime, over years, things are fading away. You could really see the char here also. It's really unfortunate, to be honest.
You know, the time period I'm most often interested in is the 1800s, the late 1800s, the pioneer period, where everything's really built of wood. So a lot of the ghost towns that, you know, from that time frame, there's just not much left anymore. And oftentimes when we're out here seeing places like this, you're really seeing stuff from later times, because keep in mind, mining went on beyond the 1800s, but really still neat, but I wish there was more.
All right, we've made our way a couple miles up the road, right across from the McDonald's and modern day casinos here in Searchlight, and boat rentals, boat storage. But up on that hill is the real reminder of the past. And I would argue the reason why Searchlight even exists today. Now I believe there was probably mining activity prior to 1900 out here, but Searchlight is really a town that came to be after the turn of the century, in the early 1900s. And these look like they play the part. Very old, rusted, fits the bill for what I think is an old mining relic. And some other shacks dotting this landscape. But other than this stuff, the headframe, and that area we just saw, I don't know of much else out here that's left today for a town that was as big as Searchlight was in its heyday, as you're gonna learn. And what better picture is there without with a billboard in the background next to this miner shack? And whatever this was, it clearly had electricity. Maybe it still has electricity. I don't know the current state of things inside of there. But that's a beauty. That is a beauty. I imagine at one point in time, this was all not overgrown. All of this, all these, whatever these are, looks like creosote maybe, probably didn't exist. It was probably a lot cleaner. And you've got other shacks back here, sheds. Can't really go in any of the buildings because they're all boarded up, but they're beautiful actually, compared to other ones that I see of this nature. This is top-notch stuff. Imagine living in here on a rainy day, how loud that roof must have been. And forget about it with hail? Hail no! Let's take a peek in here. It's really hard to get in here. But you could see this was someone's residence probably. There's a sink back there. Maybe it was a restroom, but there's also an old bed and mattress. I don't know how old that is, but clearly it's the best you're gonna get in here. I can't really get in here. Very dangerous. There's broken glass everywhere on the ground. And I'm not wearing my good boots. And you can see there's your tin roof right there. And you better believe it, that old wood smell, that, you know, the thing I always talk about on this channel, stick your head in there and you'll get a good whiff of that. I love it. Looks like this shack is open. I don't know what this was. There's like a long antenna or pole with wires coming off of it. Was that like a generator that was feeding electricity to other shacks or things? I don't know. Does anybody know about this stuff? Looks like wire to me. You could see there's some kind of sheathing on the outside exposing the, well, there's no charge. I'm your voltage meter today. I don't know if that was dumb. I don't think it was. I mean, it's pretty obvious to me that there ain't no power out here. What do we got here? This is a really, for this being right off the road, this is a really cool find. That's easily accessible to anybody if you wanted to check out something like this. This looks like it was an outhouse. Check this out. There is a I'm looking for Pappy now in here. And you could see, I'm guessing, some kind of rats or pack rats or something's making a nest in here. There's a lot of material. I've seen this kind of thing before in videos of old mines where there's lots of little choya sticky things here that those rats can make their nest of, and there's some inside of that hole. So this has really been a nice place for something to live. And you can see there's your electricity, your wiring. I don't know if there was like a ceiling at one point, and what I presume were some kind of shelves. So check this out. You don't oftentimes see really well preserved marks like that on some of this stuff. This looks like it was a Wise Service Welding Works product. Has a serial number on it of 124, and this is from 1946. You see that? An indicator that this wasn't from the 1800s, really, but it's still really cool. I wonder if this was an old workshop of some sort. Lots of gadgets and metal and tanks and mechanical parts, maybe engines, I don't know. And most of it is just crumbling. Yeah, and if you just come around this way, you can get to the back of this bigger thing, and there's a door actually that looks like it's open. Still not seeing any no trespassing signs in here, but I also don't have a flashlight or anything, but you can see like old furniture. Look at that fridge. That is a classic right there. I don't want to open it though. This is spooky. There's actually a wood-burning stove in here. I can barely see in here, by the way. My camera can see very clearly though. The low light is excellent, but let's just pan around here and see. Is there old wallpaper? in here. This is clearly someone's home, and there's an old table here in the middle of the room. I'm actually looking at my camera viewfinder to see. There's an old wood-burning stove in here. It's very cold in here, too. There's another fridge. This looks a little bit more modern than the first one we saw, but who knows? Anybody living here now?
I do want to be respectful, you know, not trespass or anything that I'm not supposed to do. But like I said, there's not a single no trespassing sign or any word of warning not to do any of the stuff that I'm doing. So my policy is just be respectful and careful and don't leave a trace and make a mess.
All right, we need to make our way up the road now to the centerpiece. But this is really well worth coming to check out if you're passing through this way. Just pull off right off the main road. So I have seen people go up there with permission and without permission. I do not have permission. I did not seek permission from anyone, and unfortunately it does look like this is private property, so I don't know if there's an alternate way to get up there, but you can actually see up on the hillside it says Colton 1897. So why don't we get into our little history lesson now?
Legend says that Searchlight got its name in May of 1897 when prospector George Frederick Colton stated it was going to take a searchlight to find gold ore out in this desert. Not long thereafter, Colton found the gold he was looking for and began the Duplex Mine. Word spread quickly and many people flooded into this area. Searchlight quickly became a boomtown, and to really put it in perspective, at the time it had a larger population than nearby Las Vegas. After 1917, the great boom was coming to an end, and by the 1920s, the population almost dwindled away to nothing. There was a small resurgence in the 1930s and 1940s due to the excitement at nearby Hoover Dam, but by the early 1950s, the remaining mining operations closed shop. Fast forward to today, and there's a population likely south of 500 people.
This very car likely worked the depths of this mine up here over 100 years ago. How cool is that? And everything I just told you is true because the sign says it too. But that's not where I got my facts today. But it's good to reconfirm. This is a real bummer though. You know, I do like to follow the rules. So I don't like to break the rules, but I am gonna try to get the drone up there to get a closer look at that headframe at the very least.
So I've heard that mine up there referred to as the Duplex Mine, and I think Colton named it that because there's multiple levels in the mine, but I've also heard it referred to as the Colton Mine, named after its founder, Mr. Colton. That's history right there. Many of you have probably driven by it, and now when you come back here in the future and you see that, because it's a very prominent landmark here in Searchlight, now you know.
Okay, so Searchlight is a prime way to get to the Mojave National Preserve area, which is where we're going, way out into the desert. So we're now not heading towards Vegas anymore. We're heading towards Nipton, California. So we're going to be crossing the border into California sometime here soon. This is Route 164, also known as Nipton Road. We actually drove this route couple years back when I did my first visit to Death Valley in this area, way back, some old school Cactus Atlas, I think it's called the November Road Trip if I'm not mistaken, and there's a really weird weather day where this place is really cloudy and stormy looking, so much different than I remember it because of that. I also think an alternate name for this is the Joshua Tree Highway, because as we get further into this, you're gonna see Joshua trees covering the landscape, one of the other features of the Mojave Desert, one of its most popular plants. I would say the Joshua tree is to the Mojave as the saguaro is to the Sonoran Desert. This is a spot that I turned off a couple years ago just to get a look at some of these Joshua trees. Walking Fox Ranch, which I think is a historic ranch.
Head south on Walking Fox.
Already I see a ranch and what I presume are old old structures, an old historic ranch right out here. This wasn't an intended stop, by the way, on this journey. It's right off of Nipton Road, or 164. But it looks like this is a BLM featured destination. Well, here we are at Walking Box Ranch, where you could see they even have handicap parking, but everything seems to be shut off and closed. So I didn't take time to study all of the details about this. I want to say that there was somebody in old Hollywood, a couple that owned this ranch and lived out here. But you could see it's, I guess, private property. Too bad, you know, because it seems like they paved this and made it accessible for visitors. So maybe it's by guided tour only or something like that. So once again, Walking Box Ranch, not an intended stop today on our tour, but thought it would be neat to come out here and get a look at some of the beautiful Joshua trees. And as the sign for Searchlight itself mentions, it's a historic mining area, but also historic ranching area. And you can see all these corrals. I assume this is where cattle would come up to be loaded on trucks or something like that. Next to this gigantic Joshua tree. Wow, that's like 2-3 stories tall right there. You can see how thick the trunks get on these things. It's like a, I don't think they're considered real trees, are they? They're a type of yucca. The king of yucca, I would say.
I might also add, if you're a loner like me and like seclusion and kind of have that desert rat in ya, the Mojave Desert is probably one of the best places you can go to get some peace and quiet. I'm gonna be surprised if I see too many people today, although it is Thanksgiving weekend, so who knows, but you don't see too many people come out this way. One of the things I oftentimes read or hear people say is, you know, Joshua Tree National Park, if you wanna see Joshua trees, there's probably no finer place to go, to be honest, with the scenery, the boulders, all of the stuff there. It's quite a sight. We've made videos there you can go check out in the past, but I also hear people talk about this region of the Mojave Desert where you don't have to deal with the crowds. I was just reading for Thanksgiving weekend, I was on one of the national park websites, and they're warning about Joshua Tree National Park, you know, not being able to find parking, and it just sounds like such a hassle. Well, come out here and you won't have any hassles, I promise you. Pretty crazy too, because when you come out of Searchlight, you don't really see too many, just one or two dotting the landscape. And out here, they grow enormous and they're in abundance. So it probably is worth getting airborne maybe and flying around here to show you how beautiful the Mojave Desert can be. Walking Box Ranch. So not a planned stop, but I'm glad I did because I really wanted to give you guys a good look at this desert.
going to be seeing a lot more of it today, though. This is just the start. So let's head on to our actual plan, next plan stop, which is Nipton, California. It's just nice to stand out here in these lonely roads in the Mojave Desert. It's so quiet out here. Occasional car passing through, but I could safely stand on the road with little worry.
I love seeing these railroads today. This railroad still operates, and I was trying to find the train schedule. It's hard to plan a trip and, you know, be here when one of these trains comes through, but Nipton really was is a town that's a good example of something that I think grew up as a stop on old railways.
And back in the day, this was a stop mainly for ranchers to load cattle, is what I read. I almost feel like doing that old trick to see if I could feel a train a-coming. Let's see. Do I feel any vibrations? I do not.
Alrighty, let's go back to the town proper and I'll give you a history lesson.
The origin of Nipton was a small mining camp located at the crossroads of two wagon trails. It sits at the northeastern edge of the Mojave National Preserve and feels like a tiny oasis against the backdrop of the vast Mojave Desert. Nipton really came to be when a railroad eventually passed through here in 1905. Back then, they called it Nipino Camp. Then in 1910, when the previous railroads merged with the Union Pacific Railroad, the name of the town changed to Nipton. In its heyday, Nipton served as a cattle loading station for nearby ranches in the area. It also serviced prospectors and miners who worked mines out in nearby areas, serving as sort of a supply and social hub for an otherwise sparsely populated and isolated community of desert dwellers. As for leftover history, there's not too much to speak of today. The highlight of the town is arguably the 1910 five-room adobe hotel. Through time, some interesting things have passed through here. A few art installations were stashed here from Burning Man, for example. At one point, Nipton attempted to become really far out by serving as a cannabis resort destination. Well, that vision was never seen through, and last I heard, the town went up for sale for about $2.75 million and was bought by a Vegas-based company around April of this year. For me, it's the last bit of shade before heading out into the endless skies of the Mojave Desert. Seems to be downtown Nipton here. You could see the Nipton Trading Post. Not sure when this building dates back to, but you could see they're closed. I think during the time of COVID, this place pretty much got wiped clean and then, you know, mentioned some of the other things they try to do with the town. But still pretty cool. There's the old Adobe Historic Hotel on private property today. Unless you're hoteling or camping here, then it looks like you'd have access. I don't know if they're open for business though, to be honest. But hopefully if it's not, they reopen this one day.
All right, let's peek on down here. A lot of the areas that I wanted to go check out are fenced off now. I've seen older videos where I don't think that was quite the case, but I'm gonna see if we could find the old schoolhouse or any other buildings of historic interest here.
That almost there looks like an old boxcar converted to some kind of old residence, which would make sense being right off of a railroad here. You can also see that they have a haberdashery on the premises here. Now that's pretty cool. And this here, I don't know what this is. This looks like some kind of touristy thing that may be consisting of old repurposed wood. Looks like old outhouses here.
I guess they don't value their privacy here. I can tell you though, that floor there just sunk in when I stepped on it. So, but this does look the part, doesn't it? Looks quite old, whatever it is.
Lots of really interesting things spread about if you keep your eyes open, like these old cars. There's a few more back there too, and a lot of RVers. If I were a betting man, I'd say that's the old schoolhouse right there. On private property, no trespassing signs. This looks like an old safe just sitting out by the road here. Don't know what else that would be. It certainly looks like a safe to me. And that's pretty funny. The railroad tracks are the one side of town, and you literally just turn. I'm standing like almost at the edge of town on the other side. That's it. That's Nipton. When I said you could drive through here and blink and miss it, I wasn't kidding.
I think most of the stuff of interest where I think you're allowed to go is right over where I parked by the, where you see the old hotel and general store. But outside of that, there's not much here.
So beyond this no trespassing sign, which they remind you every few feet, private, 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 are the Burning Man leftovers, some art installations from previous Burning Mans. That thing there, which are made of shopping carts, really cool looking. I've seen other YouTubers in the past go out there when I think you were allowed to, but man, do they got this place shut down now.
You know, that is a bummer though. I really was looking forward to getting a close-up look at that. Maybe there's a way around it, but I mean, clearly someone doesn't want you going on the property here. And if it wasn't for the railroad and this paved road through here, this would have just become yet another ghost town with very little left, if anything. So I guess I should be at least grateful that we got to see this today, which is the main reason why we came. We came for the history, not the Burning Man art.
Howdy, partners. What can I get for you?
Well, welcome to the Deadass Saloon, folks. You know, in our exploration of the Mojave Desert, I find myself in Chloride, Arizona, on my way back home to Phoenix, and I thought this was an appropriate town where the Mojave Desert starts to dwindle out and start to turn into the Sonoran Desert. I wanted to seek out a couple more Joshua trees, so maybe some of the lost Joshua trees we're gonna see for a while. So let's go take a quick look and tidy things up.
It's a very frigid, cold morning here in Chloride. Sun's already coming up to warm things up, though. Really nice, quiet town. One of our future adventures is going to take us way out beyond where we're going to search for old mines and do some off-roading, but today, like I said, we're just looking for a Joshua tree. Ooh, look, there's a miner cemetery named Boot Hill. I wonder where they got that idea from. Maybe they have a Joshua tree back here somewhere. Silver Hill Lode. I don't see any Joshua trees back here. Let's head on over this way where I think there are some actual real historic buildings. Maybe we'll find some Joshua trees over there. And like I said, I think these are some OG old buildings here. The old post office here in Chloride. Don't see a date on that, but we'll learn about that when we come back sometime. And that building, Russell, 1928. And this little antique store. I don't know if that's an actual real building or not. Have you seen any Joshua trees, sir? Oh, well, you're just gonna stay quiet, huh? Have it your way.
This town has lots of character. For a character like me.
Well, looky what I found here. That is one healthy looking Joshua tree. I don't know if we could really call this its native habitat, but these here seem to be doing quite well. That's a big one. And heading over this way, I see plenty of Joshua trees planted in people's yards. The last we're gonna see for quite a while.
Well, folks, I need to part ways with you now. What do we learn on this episode? I'm not quite sure. Probably don't want that for a roof. See you next time.